Hey everyone, this is Uday Raj and welcome to another Figma tutorial. I'm back after much needed break in this pandemic. Now you can expect more video uploads. Today's video is about new and exciting Figma update, Variants. Figma had announced this update a while ago. I was eagerly waiting for this as it lays foundation for Interactive Components 2, which is coming out in couple of months. In this video, you will be able to create and use component variants with ease and understand its true potential. This video might be lengthy as there is a lot to cover, but watch till the end as this is extremely useful feature. Timestamps are added to the description so that you can easily skip or repeat specific topic. For those who are new here, I'll add a component basics tutorial link in the description below. Make sure that you understand all the basics before checking out variants. Alright. Let me quickly show you component swapping UI update. We are using that later. Earlier, we had to drag and drop components from assets to replace them. Now it's very easy. Just click on the component instance you want to replace. Click on its instance name in the properties panel. Now you can see all the components in the same group. You can also navigate within groups or simply search, like in this case, I'll search for eye icon. You'll see all matching results in seconds. Figma makes it extremely easy to swap components. Now, without spending any more time, let's jump into hero feature of this video, variants. It's nothing but collection of components who share same properties with little variations. Tens and hundreds of duplicate entries in assets panel can be reduced into just one component. Check out this button components for example. We can see two components in assets. Important notice. If you are planning to combine existing components as variants, make sure that the layer structure is exactly the same. Otherwise, overrides won't work. Once you verify layers, select both buttons and click on Combine as Variants. As soon as you click, assets panel only show one button component. You can identify component variant as dotted purple line. To delete a variant, simply drag them outside a frame. Let's undo this and see how to use them. Drag instance of this button on canvas. Click on that. Check out this brand new property selection dropdown. We can add new variant by clicking on this plus icon in variants frame or by duplicating a component. Let's call it tertiary. You can change its visual properties. All instances are immediately updated. We can now choose button variation as primary, secondary, and tertiary. We can rename properties to something meaningful. You can do that by clicking property and changing the text. We can call this button type. It's immediately reflected in variation selection dropdown. This still doesn't look better than component swapping UI update, right? This is because we only have one property right now. It gets more interesting as we add more and more properties. You can increase variants frame by selecting and dragging the handles. To add another dimension to it, we can add new set of properties, say different states like hover, press, or inactive. To do that, select variants frame. Click on three dots and click add new property. I'll call it state. Rename default to active by double clicking on it. You can now see that all buttons have active state as selected. Select all of them and duplicate. I'll just organize them for better representation. You'll get this conflict error if properties of variants are not unique. You can easily fix that by adding another state called hover. Error is now gone. Make some visual adjustment to these states. Add new variant to add another state as pressed. Repeat this procedure to add disabled state as well. Now all of these states can have icons. So let's add one more property and call it icon. Rename default to without. Now all these variations will inherit this property. Now duplicate all 9 components and add another value in icon property. Call it width. Here I'll simply make placeholder icons visible in all of them. Just tweak colors to make it perfect. Alright, let's see this setup in action. Remember the simple button component we used earlier? Now we have lot more control over its variations. You can make any combination of type, state, and icons. It retains other properties as it is. If something is not working correctly, that's probably because the layer structure is not correct. Using this variants is fun. We can create n number of combinations in just few minutes. Here's another trick. If you have only two values in property such as on or off, you can convert it into a toggle by simply using yes or no, on or off, or true or false. Rename with and without with on or off. Now we can simply turn icons on and off. This offers endless possibilities. Ability to create radio and checkbox controls, hide and show layers, or switch between different states. It's fun using these features. I followed the same process and created this flexible form field variants. I created first column with combination to toggle left-right icons and hint text. I duplicated entire column and added new property as state. Try to recreate this on your own and let me know if you face any challenges. I can make separate video on this. You can edit any variant property such as fill, stroke, and effect just like old components. To keep things tidy and evenly spaced, you can use auto distributions by selecting all components in variants. You can reorder properties as per your preferences and rename any of the property or its value. It will reflect immediately with all the instances. You can duplicate variants if you need to have same properties but slightly different design. Like this checkbox variant here. You can duplicate and easily convert it into radio components by changing the design. It will retain the same properties and values. Lastly, to delete a single variant, you can simply delete it. Don't worry, if any of the instances is using it, you can easily restore it later. If you want to remove all the variants while keeping original components, just select all the components and drag them out of this variant's purple frame. Alright, now it's time for final showdown. Let's see if this really helps in our design process. Let's create a login and registration screen only using component variants. Just drag component variants from assets and modify the values. You can create many screens and different states in just few minutes. That's it for today. This covers basics of variants and how to use them. In the next video, I'll cover how you can convert existing component library with variants with few more hacks. Stay tuned. Hit like and share this video if this was helpful. Provide your feedback in the comments below. Thanks for watching it. I'll see you in the next one.